In this video, we explore how to find and add PDFs to your D2L Brightspace course. So let's begin at our Pima Community College library. It may resemble something like this, with a range of search options. If you're looking to do a general search, we'd recommend simply choosing the Megasearch option. If you're looking for an article, you can click on Articles and Databases, and you'll have choices which include being able to browse your databases by subject or being able to browse through that specific database. Looking a little bit closer here again, you're able to narrow by subject or by database. In this example, we're looking at a range of subjects that move from art, design, and fashion and business to literature and newspapers to videos, images, and music and world languages. Again, choose the subject area that you'd be interested in and make sure to click on that Go button in order to proceed. If instead you're looking for a chapter from a book, you're going to want to choose Books and More as your option. And then I would recommend going to the Advanced Search option, which should be visible within the pop-up. Click on Advanced Search, and then filter your search further based upon the fields that are of interest to you. For example, the author, the title, or simply any field. And choose the material type that you're looking for. In this instance, I'm choosing ebook so that I can find an ebook related to poetry and pull a specific chapter from that book. Then you'll review results. Here's an example of what that looks like. The first example is the book that I'm looking for, The Poetry of Pop by Adam Bradley. A closer look here within the Pima Community College Library. When you click on that link, it'll give you a fuller summary. What I'm aiming to do is connect to that electronic resource. So in order to do so, you'll be clicking on the hyperlinked text, which says Access to Electronic Resource. When you click on that link, it'll take you into whatever tool is hosting that specific link. It may ask you to log in using your Pima Community College username. This is an example from EBSCO where I click on the link and I'm able to find the text within EBSCO's website. I'm going to scroll down because I want to be able to find their table of contents. And as I do scroll down, you'll notice in this specific example, chapter one is not listed. Instead, there's 1, 2, and 3, which are sections of the book, but I can click on each of those. And what happens within the tool is that it opens the PDF reader within EBSCO. It brings me, if I click on, for example, lyric and song, to the PDF version of that text, which is identical to the version that is printed. Moving forward, you'll click the download icon in order to make sure that the PDF is saved to your computer. Next, you'll get a pop-up window that will ask you how many pages to download or if you want a specific range of pages. In this example, again, I'm only choosing chapter one. I will click download PDF. I am going to open it on my own computer to make sure that every page that I intended to download is visible within that PDF. And then we're going to upload it into D2L. So how do we upload those PDFs into D2L Brightspace? From within your course, and within any module from that course, you'll be clicking on the blue Upload Create button and choosing Upload Files. Then choose My Computer. Finally, you'll click on the Upload button. This will open up a pop-up window on your computer where you can select that PDF from your computer. Alternately, you can simply drag that item onto the gray Upload button. After it's fully added, you will click on the blue Add button to add it to your course. Your PDF will appear within your module resembling this PDF. In other words, the blue text is the title. You can change the title if you'd like by clicking on the drop-down arrow, or you can leave it as it is. One option that we recommend is to include source and citation information with every text that you bring into your course. In this example, I'm using the Cite button within EBSCO to pull the MLA citation that I would like to use and include inside my class. So again, I click on that Cite button, I scroll down to MLA, which is the Modern Language Association citation format I like to use, and then I return to D2L I find that same PDF, and I click on the drop-down chevron, and I choose Edit Properties in Place. Then you'll want to click on Add a Description in order to edit the description for that text. In this example, I'm going to be adding the MLA citation, which includes the title, the author, and the source. I will paste that into that description section and simply click on the blue Update button. Within D2L, this is how it appears. Again, I'm looking at the top view of that specific document. If I scroll down, I can also find the full description at the bottom, which is in this context in MLA formatting. Are you also interested in finding links to articles and ebooks? If so, we encourage you to visit our YouTube channel for Pima Online's Center for Learning Technology and look specifically at the Finding Articles and Ebooks for Teaching video. Or you could alternatively just go to our library and look at the knowledge base, which is called LibAnswers, search the FAQs, or you could contact a librarian using this Ask a Librarian tool. Again, if it's not between the hours of 8 and 5 p.m., then your answers will be responded to by librarians on the next business day. Their website is libanswers.pima.edu. Finally, you could also reach out to our FRC or CRC staff. Here is their telephone number, 520-206-6511. And that's the heart of it. To learn more about resources and strategies for online teaching, please again visit our YouTube channel or visit our Pima Online faculty guide. The website link is included in this video's description. Thanks so much.